I graduated from Fleming College in the Ecosystem Management program in 2013, and then I started at Trent in their Environmental and Natural Resource Science program. And during my time there, I did my honors thesis on environmental education at the Camp Kawartha Environment Center. And after graduating, I was offered a job there, and so I've been working here at Camp Kawartha for the last year. I think being able to kind of see your impact locally makes a big difference, and to kind of know that the students that you're interacting with, they're going to be growing up, coming to these locations time after time, and so it's great for them to know about how that they can also positively impact their communities.
One of the wonderful things about the Environment Center was built by students from Fleming College's Sustainable Building Program. So here you had 26 young people learning about sustainable living and then presenting a building that showcases what good sustainable living looks like in action. So when kids come here, they bear witness to things like a living roof, building made out of natural materials, rainwater harvesting, alternative energy systems. But at the same time, they get deep and abiding connection to nature through ecology, through hands-on games, and it's why we have about 40 different programs grounded in the curriculum, connecting kids to nature.
I deliver a program to French immersion students at the school, and but I also have a little program that we call the Habitat Helpers. We had already started by adding 3 pollinator gardens at the front of the school and getting students involved with that. And we're rejuvenating some old pollinator beds and planting a new one here, which is what you see the kids doing back here.
Students in high school are reaching the age where they can comprehend the larger picture of what's unfolding and the relationship between their community and the globe. So it's a real critical juncture for stepping out, and they have the critical thinking skills to make the connections that are so important in developing skills around sustainability. These kids care, and what they need is help knowing what to do and what the next steps are. How do they engage? How do they involve themselves in their communities to make a difference? Because they're just itching to go.
Talk about issues, environmental issues in particular, that are really interesting, that have a really depth and a long history to them, and that have a wide impact on not just human beings, but on biological life and all the way to climate change. Talk about the idea that people within our cultures, within indigenous cultures, have a different way, a different knowledge system. So we talk about the necessity of understanding knowledge systems interaction. We talk about students and providing information and knowledge to students that not only, you know, helps to stimulate their mind, but also helps to make a connection between the things that they're learning, the way their mind functions, all the way to how they feel about these different things. So we're trying to connect their mind and the heart.
Trent's had a long-standing relationship with the environmental sciences, environmental studies, since the early 1970s, when some of the program was created here at Trent, and it's grown to be one of the largest undergraduate programs in Canada, with degrees across a whole spectrum of environmental areas, from environmental geosciences and sustainable agriculture, water sciences, environmental studies, indigenous environmental studies and sciences, and we have a strong relationship with our sister college, Fleming, in the Frost campus, with degrees in ecological restoration and lots of great partnerships with them.
One of the reasons that we were designated was because of some of the community-based environmental education initiatives that have been happening around the region. So in Haliburton and City of Kawartha Lakes and Peterborough and City County, there are organizations like Green Up that offer really immersive environmental education opportunities for children ranging from really young preschoolers all the way through to high school.
I think there's a long history of working together. I think because it's a small community, we know each other. So we can get in touch with the business community through a friend, through a relative, through an associate. We can get in touch with the environmental community likewise. So I think that kind of networking has gone on for quite a long time, and I think it's been very effective.